Steve here with Surf Skate Love, here to review the Kerf board from Germany. Now, if you look up close at the Kerf board, it has a very unique truck design. It works on two dual swivels. Now, the effect of this truck is that it has one critical factor that you have to understand about the Kerf board, and I'm going to reveal what that is in this review. But first, come with me for a little demonstration test ride. Okay, so like I said, there is one important thing that you have to understand about the Kerf board, and if you have a trained eye, you may have noticed it in that test ride. And before I get to that, let me just tell you what I like about this board. First and foremost, this board is very, very easy to ride. And what that means is that it's great for beginners. For example, my 11-year-old daughter loves this board. She can ride pretty much everything that I have, but this is the one that she picked up on because it's very, very easy for her to ride. It's also a very comfortable ride. I really like this deck a lot. It's a really great size and shape for me. I also like that this is a very quality board. All of the materials used in this is very high quality. These boards, I imagine, will last quite a long time. Now, with all that said, I don't ever ride this board, and it's for that one reason that I told you. Let me just show you what this is. So come down with me. The bottom line is, when you look at this truck, because it only has one dimension of motion side to side, what that means is that you get very, very little rail to rail lean when you turn. In fact, you can see on this how these back wheels will lift up. If I turn too far, that back wheel is lifting up. What it means is that I can't do any real aggressive leaning on this. So just to compare this, let me show you how this looks on other boards. So for example, here is the Smooth Star Thruster. Look at the lean you get on this. Here's a Yao S5. Same thing. Here's a Yao Meraki. Here's the Waterborne Surf Adapter. You can see that deep rail-to-rail lean that you get on a traditional surf skate truck. Here's the slide. We've got a Carver C7 here. So now that you know what you're looking for, let me just demonstrate this again and I'll talk this out with you. The very first thing that this lack of lean means in this truck is that it doesn't incentivize a true surf skate pump with compression and extension, that going up and down movement. Instead, I have to use my front hip and my front foot to do a lot of side to side action, because it doesn't, without lean, doesn't respond to that up and down compression and extension as much as some of these other boards do. So again, if you can just see, it's a lot of twisty side to side is how this truck works. Now, the second thing this means is that I can't get aggressive on turns, because if I try to lean on it like I'm used to on other surf skates, it just doesn't lean. And so my body ends up kind of just falling off of it. If I really try to lean into this, and then also you'll notice that when I'm leaning, this truck gets kind of squirrely on me. These front tires will move around quite a bit. So it's not very comfortable carving at all. And it's that lack of lean that is the one big issue that I have with the Kerf board. And that's why I don't ride it very often. And it's honestly why I don't really call it a true surf skate. What I call this is a pumpable longboard cruiser, because to me, that's really what it's built for. You can go long distances on this. Like I said, it's very comfortable for long rides, but you're just not getting that true compression and extension on a surf skate pump that you want. And you're not getting as tight carving with that good surf skate lean that I like. So who do I recommend this board for? Honestly, I put this board in the novelty category. And what I mean by that is once you've covered your, what I call your five bases, which in my opinion are Yao, Smoothstar, Carver, Slide, and Waterborne Surf Adapter, then you can think about getting a Curve board if you want to try the experience and just try something new. I put it in the same category of, say, like a Ham boards, where I would absolutely not recommend it for your first surf skate at all. It's really just something if you're curious about the experience. But I can just tell you right now, the number one thing that you're going to notice is that it doesn't have very much lean. And that's my take on the Curve board.